of the premier institutions in India, and it offers coaching for examinations like UPSC, State Public Service Commission, SSC Combined Graduate Level Exams and CLAT exams. So do visit AKS IAS Academy and also the website aksias.com. About me, I am Sandeep Bhushan Tumala, and my credentials are: I have 10 years of teaching experience for civil services. I teach international relations and internal security and analysis of the Hindu newspaper. And my session will definitely help you to crack prelims and mains examinations, because I would be emphasizing on the keywords and the key phrases. Which will be certainly useful for you. And these keywords and the key phrases will certainly help you to crack prelims by making sure that we will identify the factual, analytical and the conceptual questions which will be useful for prelims examination. So thereby, by emphasizing on the keywords and the key phrases, we will definitely have an edge in the preliminary examinations. And the other important thing what we will also learn from identifying the keywords and the key phrases, not only just for prelims point of view, but also in regards to the mains point of view, that is in regards to the answer writing. So definitely your answer writing, you will have a better or a improvised answer writing skills by imbibing the keywords and the key phrases in your answer writing, that is in the mains examination. Because when you imbibe the keywords and the key phrases in your answer writing, your answers would be precise and would be concise. And this is what the UPSC will be expecting from you, that your answers should be precise and concise so that you can score high marks in the mains examination. So therefore, my emphasis, that is in regards to the identifying and imbibing the keywords in the answer writing, will help you in the mains. And by identifying the keywords and the key phrases will help you identify the factual, analytical and conceptual questions for the prelims point of view. Therefore, my session will help you for both prelims and mains for 2020 as well as 2021. And today's session is in regards to the daily news analysis, that is today's DNA, 10th of August 2020. And before I get to the topic, I would be reiterating my tagline, that is emphasizing on the keywords and the key phrases, that is the importance, because this will certainly help you for prelims and mains and make you comfortable even in the interview. So the keywords and the key phrases are very, very important, and that is the tagline. I keep on emphasizing that it is very important, and this is from the daily news and analysis. We will emphasize on the keywords and the key phrases. And before we get into the topic, that is a daily news analysis, there is a quote of the day. The quote of the day is: a river cuts through the rock. A river cuts through the rock, or through a rock, not because of its power. Not because of its power, but because of its persistence. What do you mean by persistence? I read once again. A river cuts through a rock, not because of its power, but it's because of its persistence. Persistence is continuous efforts. Continuous efforts. And this is what is important in your preparation. So your continuous efforts, that is why I always emphasize consistency. Is your continuous efforts what is required, that a river cuts the rock, but it's not because of the power of the flow of the water, that is flow of the river. No, it is because of the persistence. So even this can be very well applied to you, I mean in your preparation. That is, what is important is persistence, even in your throughout your preparation to achieve your goal, to be successful. Persistence, continuous efforts are very, very important. A river cuts through a rock, not because of its power, but because of its persistence. And before I get into the daily news analysis, I would say very good morning to everyone, the one who is in the live and also in the live chat. Rahul, Arika, D. Suvarna, Shravani, AVS, Krishna, Praveen Kumar, Bhargav, ASO, KP Puram. Okay, very good morning, Bhargav. I think it's your first class. Very good morning to you. And welcome to AKS IAS Academy Daily News Analysis by me, that is Sandeep Bhushan Thummala. Because the rest, everyone is all the old students. Bhargav, I think you are the new one. Welcome to AKS IAS Academy Daily News Analysis. And the news is Defense Minister to impose import embargo. So here the Defense Ministry is to impose what? Import embargo. Embargo means ban. Embargo is ban. So the Defense Ministry has gone ahead with taking a decision to impose a ban on imports of 101 items. And the Defense Minister Rajnath Singh has gone ahead with this decision, that is embargo on 101 items in regards to the import embargo. I said embargo means it's a ban. So ban on imports. Imports in regards to what? In regards to defense equipments. Ban in regards to the defense equipment. Why ban on defense equipment? Because India wanted to boost indigenous manufacturing units. Indigenous manufacturing unit. So to boost indigenous manufacturing unit. So again, why to boost indigenous manufacturing unit? Because it is Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan. So please do understand this. Defense Minister Rajnath Singh has announced the ban on imports or imports embargo on 101 items, that is ban on imports of 101 defense equipment items. Not only just ban on imports, but we have also looked at that he wanted to increase the exports also. First is to go ahead with banning on the imports. Why? Because to boost the indigenous manufacturing unit, so that the indigenous companies will get into the mode of production or manufacturing of the defense equipment. And why boosting the indigenous manufacturing unit? Because it is part of Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan, that is self-reliant. So this is very important. And this again, why? Welfare schemes, part of the welfare schemes. Please do understand how we are linking it. The Defense Ministry going ahead with the ban on imports or import embargo on the defense equipment is based on the Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan, that is self-reliant. That is self-reliant. And this 101 ban on items comprises of the artillery guns, the assault rifles, the corvettes or sonar systems, the transport aircrafts, and then light combat aircrafts, radars, and then also wheeled armored fighting vehicles. wheeled armored fighting vehicles. So all these have been part of, I mean, these are all the weapon systems, artillery guns, assault rifles, sonar systems, transport aircrafts, light combat aircrafts or radars, wheeled armored fighting vehicles are the one which are part of, which are part of the major part of the 101 items which have been put banned. And this ban will start between 2020, total ban will take place between 2020 and 2024. And this is important, again, all these are very important for prelims point of view, because it is an welfare scheme, Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan scheme, Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan scheme. So based on this, we need to find out, we need to identify that the imports would be, ban on imports would be between 2020 till 2024. So another 4 years, the government has taken an initiative that it will go ahead with boosting indigenous manufacturing unit, part of Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan, self-reliant. Okay, before I get into the next topic, Siddha Krishna, Manjunath and Ashwin Kumar have joined. Very good morning to you. And the government intends to go ahead with, in regards to the Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan scheme, part of the Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan scheme, the government wanted to go ahead with having this or indigenous manufacturing units, supporting the indigenous manufacturing unit with a turnover of $25 billion. So that amount of $25 billion amount of defense equipment will be manufactured in India by the Indian manufacturing units, by the Indian manufacturing units, defense equipment or defense products also you can say. And what India also, or defense minister also wanted to make sure is that they also focus on the export, not only restricting the imports and then supporting the indigenous manufacturing unit of $25 billion, but also focusing on the export. So what is that government is focusing on the exports? That by supporting the indigenous manufacturing unit, by produce or manufacturing more of the defense product, India also would wish to export to another, I mean various other countries, of products worth $5 billion. So export is $5 billion. And then in regards to the indigenous manufacturing units, the market will be $25 billion. And the government is also, has also focused that any project which is, any project or any government contract, any government contract which is above or over, above 200 crore rupees, which is over 200 crore rupees, there you will not have any, no foreign company. So any project by the government which is in regards to the defense, which is having, which a product or the contract, government contract is over, is above 200 crores, there you will not have any foreign company. That means they will support only the Indian manufacturing units. The concept of Atmanirbhar Bharat, that is, be vocal about local, be vocal about local. So the government contract which is over 200 crores, there you will not find any foreign companies, you will have Indian companies itself. And also the government has come up with the bifurcating or separate budget has been taken up. This is again very important for prelims. And also in regards to the way you write an answer, the using the keywords and the key phrases. So separate budget is being created with 52,000 crore rupees for, this is very important, for domestic capital procurement, for domestic capital procurement. And then the bifurcation has taken place in regards to the budget, defense budget. Defense budget bifurcation has taken place, that is in regards to the domestic capital procurement, and the other one is foreign capital procurement. So this is again very important. Defense budget has been separated in regards to the two, that is domestic capital procurement. Domestic, that means whatever we wanted to procure domestically by supporting indigenous manufacturing unit, so that is separated by almost 52,000 crore rupees. And any project, government contract project, which is over 200 crore rupees, there will not be any foreign companies part of the contract. And the defense budget separated into two, domestic capital procurement, foreign capital procurement. So these all are very, very important for prelims point of view. Why again I'm saying this is because of the scheme taken up by the or else government scheme in regards to the self-reliant. So these are very, very important for prelims point of view. Do understand the importance of Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan scheme. Okay, before I get into the topic, Madhu has joined, Mari Krishnaya, Vijaya, all have joined. Very good morning to you all. M. Krishnaya, is it daily live program at this time? Okay, first of all, Mari Krishnaya, very good, warm welcome to you to AKS IAS Academy live YouTube channels, that is Daily News Analysis. And yes, Krishna, this is daily you have the program, that is the live program at AKS IAS Academy YouTube channel, wherein a daily news analysis will be taken up by me, that is Sandeep Bhushan, at 7:30 daily morning, Monday to Saturday, daily morning. And you can definitely take benefit of the daily news analysis by AKS IAS Academy from Monday to Saturday, 7:30 a.m. And it is a great opportunity to the Indian defense industry, as I said, because here what is very important is the defense is looking at their own design. This is very important, own design. So here the concept is the we wanted to go ahead with the defense products or defense equipment by using our own design, and the design from or else the development capabilities. So these are very important. So the own design is taken into consideration or used, and then development capabilities or adopting, or defense, Indian defense will go ahead with this to manufacture the goods, or else in regards to making sure that they will have the design and develop. They will have the design and develop. So this is very important, design and develop. Why I'm saying all this is because these keywords are very important while you're writing in the mains examinations, or the design and developed by DRDO. This is very important. So the Indian defense wants to go ahead with manufacturing the defense products or defense equipment on their own design and developmental capabilities, that is Indian or defense itself, or otherwise designed and developed by DRDO. So it will be Indian defense or the DRDO will come into existence to require or to go ahead with meeting the armed forces requirement in regards to the manufacturing locally. And this is part of, as I said, Atmanirbhar Bharat initiative. And our defense minister has also made it very clear, this is very important. Probably many of the civil servant aspirant may miss this point, may miss this keyword, Swadeshi movement. Our defense minister has said that the government will push this Swadeshi movement started by our freedom fighter Mahatma Gandhi during the independence movement. So why I am emphasizing this point here is, as it is not really very closely packed with the 101 embargo, import embargo on the defense products. It is not really, linked to it. But why we need to focus is, as I said, many of the civil servant aspirants will not focus. But you have to focus because he has made a point on the Swadeshi movement. So why I'm saying is this keyword could be in your prelims or maximum in your mains, or maximum I'm saying mains, wherein the question could be asked in regards to linking the Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan scheme with Swadeshi movement. Please do understand, 2020 and then before 1947, Swadeshi movement. So do understand, in the mains history part, they would ask a question wherein linking the Swadeshi movement prior to India, or else by our freedom fighter Mahatma Gandhi during the freedom struggle or independence movement, during the independence movement, the Swadeshi movement, and linking it with the Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan scheme in 2020 or 21st century. Please do understand my explanation, so that this is very important, how you have to link, and linking is very important. Linking from one topic to another topic is very, very important, and it is the need of the hour as a strategy for the civil servant aspirant. And that is why I am making it very clear that you need to focus in this way. So link the Swadeshi movement with the Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan, that is self-reliant. Are you all getting it? This is very important, and I'm reiterating that many of the civil servant aspirant might miss this Swadeshi movement linking with the Atmanirbhar Abhiyan scheme, Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan scheme, which is self-reliant with the 21st century, during the independence movement. And before I get to the topic, Veerachari has joined. Very good morning to you, Veerachari. And then Prime Minister launches farm infra scheme. So what is the keyword here is, which we need to focus, is farm infra scheme. Farm infrastructure scheme. So again, this is very, very important because this is part of the government scheme. And this is again in regards to the agriculture, again focusing on the farmer's income, which will be very useful for prelims as well as mains examination, both for prelims and mains examination. So our Prime Minister has gone ahead with launching new financing scheme. So this scheme was launched by our Prime Minister under 1 lakh crore Agriculture Infrastructure Fund. This is again very important. Farm infrastructure scheme is a keyword, new financing scheme is a keyword, and then the third one is Agriculture Infrastructure Fund. So this scheme is for what? Providing fund. Fund for what? Agriculture infrastructure. So developing, or what do you say, making sure that there is more of efforts put in regards to the agriculture infrastructure. And why this agriculture infrastructure 1 lakh crore fund is been taken up as a new financing scheme? Because it focuses on storage, it focuses on processing. This is very, very important, I am saying, for the agriculture point of view, primary sector, agriculture, farmers, because our Prime Minister Narendra Modi has promised that the farmers' income will be doubled by 2022. Farmers' income will be doubled by 2022. So all these are part of the schemes to make sure that the Indian farmers' income will be doubled by 2022. And what is that 1 lakh crore agriculture infrastructure fund is meant for? It is meant for storage, it is meant for processing, and this processing is very important, because once you have the storage and processing facility, so what they can do is the produce by the farmers can be stored and processed in the it could be in cold storage, and once they are stored and processed in various and then stored in the cold storage, those produce or farm produce can be sold later on in the future date, and they will get higher price, so that they can store the product, they can process the product produce, that is I'm talking of the agriculture produce, and they can later on, they in the sense farmers can later on sell it, and they can get higher prices, and that is very important. And this scheme that is in regards to the agriculture infrastructure fund supports whom? It supports the farmers and it supports the PSEs. All these are very, very important for the mains. Please do take it as a short note for your mains. Please do write it in your book or your paper what you are carrying. Short notes. So it is beneficial, or it will support the farmers and PSE. What is PSE? Primary Agricultural Credit Society. Primary Agricultural Credit Societies. And the third one is FPO. What are FPO? Farmer Producers Organizations. So there are organizations for the farmers, the one who produces, and those organizations are called as Farmer Producer Organization. And the fourth one, it will be supporting, that is Agriculture Infrastructure Fund will be supporting the agri entrepreneurs, and all this will be supporting in what? In regards to supporting community or building the community farmers or farming assets and post harvest agriculture infrastructure. I repeat once again, the Agriculture Infrastructure Fund will support the farmers, will support the primary agricultural credit societies. So you have the societies, you have the organizations. All these are very important keywords. Please do understand. Probably you might really not have such a kind of seriousness now, but definitely this is very important. These keywords are important. So societies are beneficiary, supported, farmers, individuals, organizations are supported, and then entrepreneurs are also supported. So individuals, societies, organizations, and entrepreneurs. So please do understand this ISOE, individuals, that is farmers, or you can take FSOE are supported by the Agriculture Infrastructure Fund. Farmers, societies, organizations, and entrepreneurs. Why? Because this will build in the sense it will create or increase. What it will increase? Community farming assets in the sense their income, and post harvest, that is after harvesting, that is after the crop has has come to a stage wherein we can harvest it and we can sell it in the market. So post harvest agriculture infrastructure. So what is again post harvest agriculture infrastructure? That is nothing but storage and processing, what we have said here, storage and processing. And this is very important. And next is, these assets which we are talking about, community farming assets, will enable farmers to get greater value for produce. So definitely the ultimate point here is to make sure that there is storage facility and processing facilities, and this will create what? It will create greater value. It will create greater value to farmers, especially farmers in regards to what? In regards to the assets, their income. So they can store and they can sell at a higher prices, as I said. And when they can store and sell at a higher prices, so when there is a storage facility and processing facility, what is the benefit is, there is reduce of wastage. There is no or minimum wastage will happen, and they will increase the processing and value addition. So what is benefit is reducing of wastage or minimum wastage is taken into consideration, and then they will increase processing. So they can increase processing, and not only that, they can add value. That is what we are talking about, great value assets. So value addition is added here. So this is what is important. So all these are definitely part of your prelims, and also short notes. You can take short notes as a mains point of view, that how the new financing scheme will help the farmers in regards to the post harvest agriculture infrastructure development by storage and processing facilities, setting up the storage and processing facilities. And before I get into the topic, Mohammed Suhana has joined. Very good morning to you. Welcome to AKS IAS Academy Daily News Analysis by me, that is Sandeep Bhushan. And she says, thank you for guiding us. Yes, definitely I am there to guide you at any given point of time through AKS IAS Academy. So please do visit AKS IAS website also for further . And Mr. Modi said that the farmers and agriculture sector. So this will help the farmers and the agriculture sector. And what will it will boost is, this will boost the increase. It will boost and increase India's ability to compete on the global stage. This is very important. Global stage, farmers competing in the global stage. So who are competing in the farmer in the global stage? Farmers are competing. This is very important key phrase. So it will boost and increase India's ability, that is Indian farmers ability to compete on the global stage. On the global stage, please do understand, this is very, very important when it comes to the subsidies or Indian farmers being provided subsidies in the international market. That is what it is, global stage. And India has a huge opportunity, that is, we were talking about the post-harvest management. So what is important is here, post harvest management, this keyword is important, and focusing on the post harvest management, the agriculture infrastructure fund, that is new financing scheme, has focused on storage and processing, and that is part of the post harvest management. Post harvest management, and this will have solutions in regards to what? Warehousing means that wherein you can store it. And then you have the cold chain, that is cold storage asset, wherein they store your all the agriculture produce at given temperature, wherein it can be stored for more than 6 months depending upon the produce, 6 months, 1 year also. And then food processing, and then build global presence. So these, all these keywords are very important, that you can mention it in your answers. How the farmers would be benefited by the Atmanirbhar Bharat package 3, that is Agri Infrastructure Fund by the Government of India. And Gopi Nayak, very good morning to you. Satyanarayan Kota also, very good morning to you. Welcome to AKS IAS Academy. And this is Atmanirbhar Bharat package part 3, that is 1 lakh crore Agri Infrastructure Fund. So for farm gate infrastructure for farmers. So as I said, 1 lakh crore, this is part of it, and the else we have discussed. And there is another news which talks about hopes of farmers source for additional rate. So definitely the Prime Minister has also come up with the sixth installment of Pradhan Mantri अगेन दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर प्रीलिम्स एंड मेंस पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू. प्रधानमंत्री किसान सम्मान निधि, प्रधानमंत्री किसान सम्मान निधि wherein the prime minister has started the sixth installment. So this is again what? Providing the financial support, providing financial support for farmers, for farmers. So this is, the prime minister has launched the sixth installment of Pradhan Mantri Kisan Samman Nidhi of giving what? Investments, or providing investment support to or for agriculture. So as I said, it is for the farmers. What it is providing? It is providing investment support. It is providing investment support to the farmers. That is, now this is the launch of the sixth installment under the Pradhan Mantri Kisan Samman Nidhi, and this is the keyword here. Keyword here is Pradhan Mantri Kisan Samman Nidhi, and this what it will go ahead is by DBT, that is Direct Benefit Transfer Scheme. It will transfer rupees 2000 into the accounts of the farmers in three installments, three equal installments in the gap of 4 months. So every 4 months you have this accordingly, and the first time, the first installment has been taken up in December 2018. But the Pradhan Mantri Kisan Samman Nidhi has been launched formally in February 24th 2019. Please do understand, this is again very important for prelims point of view. So Pradhan Mantri Kisan Samman Nidhi was formally launched by our Prime Minister on February 24, 2019 in Gorakhpur. Where is Gorakhpur? That is in UP. So the Pradhan Mantri Kisan Samman Nidhi has been formally launched in Gorakhpur on February 24, 2019. But the first installment of the investment support, the first installment of the investment support to the farmers under the Pradhan Mantri Kisan Samman Nidhi has been first installment or first 4 months. For the first 4 months, December 2018. That is, this is gap of duration, gap of 4 months. So December 2018 it has started, and second we will look at now. So these are very important for the prelims point of view. That is, first it has been launched in Gorakhpur February, but the first installment, that is investment support, has been brought up through the direct benefit transfer scheme in three installment, with giving a financial support of rupees 2000. So as we discussed, first installment was December 2018. This is for your information I'm giving. Second installment has taken place in April 2019. And this, every time it is gap of 4 months. Duration of 4 months, equal installments of ₹2000 will be created into the account of the farmers through the direct benefit transfer scheme. And third installment has been in August 2019, and the fourth installment, that is March 2020, and the fifth installment is again this is December, because every 4 months, December 2019, and then fifth is April 2020, and now the sixth is now in the month of August 2020. So if you look at the duration here, it is 4 months. Every time it is 4 months. December 2018 first, April 2019 second, third August 2019, again December 2019 fourth, fifth one April 2020, sixth one August 2020. So this is the sixth installment of providing the investment opportunity, providing investment opportunity, and that will benefit 8.55 crore. This scheme will benefit 8.55 crore farmers by direct benefit transfer scheme of rupee 2000, and the total outlay for this is 17,100 crore rupees. So total outlay is, the total outlay is 17,100 crore in the next 10 days. So this is very important, how the government of India under the Prime Minister, that is the Prime Minister of India, is going ahead with protecting the farmers, or going ahead with giving the agriculture investment fund, and then this is in regards to the making sure that they will have the installment being put or credited into their farmers through the direct benefit transfer under the Pradhan Mantri Kisan Samman Nidhi. And this is again a scheme, please do understand, all the schemes are very, very important, and especially the schemes in regards to the farmers, or particularly in regards to the agriculture sector, is very, very important. So this is, as I said, this is a sixth under the Pradhan Mantri Kisan Samman Nidhi, 6,000 direct benefit transfer scheme per annum. This is per annum 6,000, because 4 × 3, this is 4 months, 3 quarters. So each quarter 2,000 rupees into 3 months, I mean 3 times. So this is 6,000 rupees per annum. Please do understand, this is per annum, that is per year or per year. This is very important. Do not get confused. Please do not get confused. As I said, 2,000, that is every 4 months. I have said here very clearly 4 months. So in a year it will be 4 × 3, that is 4 months into 3 quarters. 1 quarter × 3. 2,000 × 3, that is 6,000 rupees per year. This is very important. So this is, which scheme is that being provided 6,000 per annum? That is the under the Pradhan Mantri Kisan Samman Nidhi through the electronic DBT, direct benefit transfer. See, 8.55 crore farmers will be benefited. Total outlay is 17,000 crores and cumulative transfer of 90,000 crore. To 10 crore farmers have been, what do you say, cumulative benefit has been taken place, or it has been credited into farmers under the Pradhan Mantri Kisan Samman Nidhi scheme. And this is very, very important for prelims as well as mains examination. And before I get into the next, it is, I would say, very good morning to Ram Kumar, very good morning to you, and then Prasad also, very good morning to you. Welcome to AKS IAS Academy Daily News Analysis. And you have the another news which talks about Andaman Nicobar will be maritime hub. So here the keyword is maritime hub. And here again our Prime Minister Narendra Modi has made it very clear that he wanted to go ahead with developing a maritime hub. And this is a maritime and a startup hub. It is a maritime and a startup hub. Maritime and a startup hub. And where he has announced this or launched, he has announced this maritime hub and a startup hub will be launched in Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Why? Because Andaman and Nicobar Islands are very strategically important for India. When did we come across this Andaman and Nicobar Islands in our daily news analysis in the AKS IAS Academy YouTube channel? When did we come across? Last week, almost 10 days back. Can anyone say when did this news come up? The Andaman Nicobar Islands region, that is, I was talking about the eastern part of Indian Ocean, I did say. When did this news come up? Please tell me, which it was in regards to what? And not only this, maritime hub, he has gone ahead with making it that he will go ahead with the part of it, because this will be part of the development initiative. So as our, I mean, the India government or the government of India has promised going ahead or taking up development initiatives. Yes, Madhu has made it very clear. US India naval exercise. When naval exercise, that is US Nimitz, has passed the Philippine island or Philippine sea or else the South China Sea, and from the Malacca Strait it has entered into Eastern Indian Ocean, and at the Andaman Nicobar Islands we have gone ahead with India US naval exercise. So this we need to, I mean, you all need to that link. Okay, AVS Krishna has asked a question. Yeah. US Nimitz and US Ronald Reagan, or US and this Reagan, when you are saying Ronald Reagan, this US, this is, this was not part of it. It has come up. US Nimitz has come here. But definitely US Nimitz and Reagan has been taken part in, along with another five to seven warships in the Philippine Sea or South China Sea. Krishna has said, sir, for 1 acre or for one farmer? For the beneficiary, for the farmer. That is the head of the farmer, that is the family. For the farmer, the family, that is. So this is part of the maritime hub is strategically important, which is located in Andaman Nicobar Islands, and this is part of the development initiative by the government of India. Development initiative by the government of India for family, that is farmer's family. Yes. And not only that, he has also gone ahead with inaugurating a submarine optical fiber cable, and this is very important for prelims point of view. Why I'm saying is because there could be a question that the government of India or the Prime Minister of India has launched the submarine optical fiber cable in which among the following areas. So he has launched the inauguration, I mean it will happen today, August 10th, the submarine optical fiber cable will be launched today between Chennai and the island, that is Andaman Nicobar Islands. This is very important for prelims point of view, between Chennai and Andaman Nicobar Islands, and this will make the island, now once this is been totally done, submarine optical fiber cable has been inauguration has been taken place, and from Chennai to Andaman Nicobar Islands, then the Andaman Nicobar Islands will be digitally independent. This again keyword is very important. Why I'm saying is, when there is a question in the mains, in regards to the Indian Ocean, please do mention this. Please do mention the maritime and startup hub, and then please do mention about this submarine optical fiber, because Andaman Nicobar Islands part of the Indian Ocean, wherein India's or the government of India's initiative of development initiative making the Andaman Nicobar Islands digitally independent. So please do understand this, very very important for both for prelims I am saying, and mains also. When a question is given in regards to the mains, wherein he is talking about the Indian Ocean or the initiatives taken by the government of India to counter China, to counter China in Indian Ocean region or IOR, Indian Ocean region. Please do understand, do not take it light. It is very important when you link it. Otherwise, you look at it as that it is not really important. And this will link the 12 islands of archipelago, and it will have a high impact, and it will be a very high impact project. And this submarine, that is digitally independent Andaman Nicobar Islands, will definitely boost trade. And the other one is, it will boost trade. Please do take these points. Please do take these points. These are very, very important. Please do take this point. It will boost trade. And this boosting of the trade of the Andaman Nicobar Islands people would be based on sea-based, organic and coconut-based products. So sea-based, organic and then coconut-based products will be, can be make sure that it will boost the trade. That is, economy of the Andaman Nicobar Island people also will flourish. So this is very, very important. Please do understand. There are various keywords which I mentioned, which will be useful for prelims as well as mains examinations. Okay, Madhav, Madhu, they say, yes, per ration card, per family, 6,000 rupees, absolutely. And this is again very important, as I said, this is in regards to the developmental initiative. This news is in regards to the developmental initiative taken by the government of India. Not only that, this is again important from geography map based. So, please do look it from different aspects. This is very important. From different aspects you need to look at. So, this Andaman Nicobar Islands will be an important center and it will be part of the blue economy. Please look at it, how it is very important to identify the keywords and the key phrases which will be useful for you in the prelims, conceptual, factual and analytical question for the prelims. So for the blue economy and maritime hub, and the third one is as a startup hub. Please do understand, as a startup hub. So the first one, blue economy, it will help. It will, I mean, Andaman Nicobar Islands are strategically very important, and they are also important in regards to the blue economy, maritime and startup hub. And there would be a national highway also in the developmental part of the developmental initiative. There would be a national highway which is stretching around 300 kilometers in the Andaman Nicobar Islands itself. And they will also, they in the sense part or as part of the developmental initiative, the government of India will also improve, please you understand all this, improve air connectivity, not only national highways, but it will also improve the air connectivity within the Andaman Nicobar Islands and also from the Andaman Nicobar Islands to the rest of the country. Very, very important. All these points, please do understand, for the mains and prelims point of view in regards to, as I said, part of the IOR initiatives taken or developmental and strategical initiatives taken by the government of India to counter China in the Indian Ocean region, especially in the Eastern Indian Ocean, that is along the Andaman Nicobar Islands. Fine. And this is again why important role. This is because this is self-reliant India project. So again, this is part of the Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan scheme. Self-reliant. And it is part of the growth of new India. All these keywords are very, very important. Growth of new India. Why? Because as I said, this is the part of the developmental initiatives taken up by the government of India. And what is very important is, again here, see, look at it, Defense Minister, Prime Minister. Defense Minister has spoken about what? The Swadeshi movement, and I said link it with the Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan scheme. Fine. Prime Minister here is talking about the freedom movement, which the Andaman archipelago has been part of the freedom movement, or it has, they have the significance. Andaman archipelago have the significance in the freedom movement. And again, now with the self-reliant India project or Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan scheme, link it. So again, from the freedom or Indian history, from Maine's point of view, or in regards to the freedom movement in regards to the Maine's point of view history. So how did, or else the role of highlight the role of or emphasize the role of the Andaman archipelago in the freedom movement or India's freedom movement. So you never know how the questions, and this is how the linking has to be. So our Prime Minister has said, Mr. Modi has said, highlighting the Andaman archipelago's significance in the freedom movement. So UPSC will focus, and there could be a question in the mains. So you all will be surprised. Many of the civil servant aspirants will be surprised why this question is being asked this year. That is the 2020 mains examination, because our Prime Minister has emphasized it, because Defense Minister has emphasized in regards to the Swadeshi movement. So Swadeshi movement, Andaman archipelago. These two keywords are very important for mains point of view. I think you are all understanding the way I am trying to link it. How best we can try to make sure that two different issues bring together and then form a question for the mains point of view. And see, look at, from Chennai, you will have this submarine, as I said, this submarine optical fiber cable. Submarine optical fiber cable from Chennai to islands. So I have taken this picture image, which will be definitely submarine optical fiber cable from Chennai to Andaman Nicobar Islands. And again, this is very important. See, there might be a question again, geography map based, in regards to the islands from north to south. Arrange the islands in the Andaman Nicobar Islands from north to south. So Rangat, north, south of Rangat is Long Islands, south of Long Islands is Havelock, because it has been asked almost a decade back, this question was asked. And then south of Havelock is Port Blair, south of Port Blair is Little Andaman, south of Little Andaman is Kar Nicobar, south of Kar Nicobar is Kamarota, and then south of Kamarota is Great Nicobar. Because there was once a question asked that Kamarota Island in the Andaman Nicobar Islands is between which among the following two islands. So they have given Little Andaman and then Greater Nicobar, they have given Kar Nicobar and Greater Nicobar, they have given Long Islands and then Kar Nicobar. So this is very important. So Kamarota was asked in the prelims, in the UPSC exam. So this again, for the geography map based, I have taken this image for your benefit, which will be useful for the prelims point of view. So by launching or inaugurating the submarine optical fiber cable, maritime hub, and then startup hub, developmental initiative, National Highway 300 kilometers, air connectivity, self-reliant India project, all these are very, very important in regards to, again, blue economy also for prelims point of view. Based on that, there could be a question, geography map based. Okay, before I get into the next topic, I would just read what Ashwini Ravikumar has said. Sir, linking ideas or broadening the lookup of the news. Yes, so that is what I mean, that reflects when you are able to link, it reflects that you are very close to UPSC. You are actually following what UPSC is demanding from you, how you need to get into the mode of right strategy to crack prelims, mains and get through the interview. And there is another news which talks about amid pandemic, India and Pak spar. So there is a little bit of not very happy moments or not cordial relations between India and Pakistan in regards to the Indus water. So what is the keyword here is Indus water. So the keyword here what we need to focus is Indus water, which is between India and Pakistan. So there is a Indus water treaty between India and Pakistan. And why it is in news? Why this is in news, Indus water treaty? Because Indus water treaty is way back in the year 1960. But why is it in news? Because Indus water treaty, you have the commissioners. You have Indus water commissioners. As per the treaty, you have the commissioners, and these commissioners from both the sides, both India and Pakistan, they have the discussions or they have the meetings. Every year they have the meetings in regards to the how the Indus water treaty is actually taken up, whether there are any disputes, whether any country has any concerns in regards to the whether the other opponent country or the other country is not following the Indus water treaty. So that will be discussed through the Indus water commissioners from the both the sides, that is India and Pakistan. There would be meeting held, and the last meeting which has been held between India and Pakistan by the Indus water commissioners as part of the Indus water treaty was October last year. This meeting has taken place. Last meeting between India and Pakistan is October 2019, and the next meeting was to be scheduled in March 2020, but because of the COVID-19 pandemic situation, the meeting has been put on hold. But India said that we will go ahead with the meeting. But the meeting, we said, we will go ahead with the video conferencing. But Pakistan has refused. To go ahead with the Indus water treaty by the Indus water commissioners meeting through the video conference, which was supposed to take place on in the month of or else before March 31st, 2020. As Pakistan has refused, now India has refused the request. Now Pakistan has requested, India that we will go ahead with the Indus water treaty meeting. But now India has refused the Pakistani request to have a meeting in regards to the Indus water treaty at the Athari checkpost, near the India-Pakistan border. And this meeting, as I said, by the Indus water commissioners, and this discussion by the meeting, the discussions what will be taken up is about the construction of dams. Because if there are any dams which are being constructed on the rivers, wherein the three rivers were, as per the Indus Water Treaty, the World Bank, which was the mediator, has given three rivers to Pakistan and three rivers to India. So eastern flowing and then western flowing rivers. Fine, we will look at it. Eastern flowing rivers three, western flowing rivers through India. So whether there are any construction of dams which have been set, which have been constructed, will be taken up illegally or not without the consent of the other country, would be taken up as a part of the meeting in the Indus Water Treaty yearly meetings initiated by the Indus Water Commissioners. And whether there are any hydropower projects. Please do understand, whether there are any construction of the dams or whether there are any hydropower projects or any concern, any other concern from the both the countries would be discussed in the Indus Water Treaty meeting. So this is actually there. And what is important is India. Why it is in news? Because India has refused. Why? Because India has refused the request. Because why India has refused now? Because Pakistan has refused. That when India has requested that we will go ahead with a video conferencing meeting before March 31st in regards to the Indus Water Treaty, which they did not accept. Who? Pakistan. That is why there is a difference. And what are the key points which there is a difference is that there is a runoff river. So there is a runoff the river on Chenab River. That is on the Chenab River in the Kishtwar district. This is again very important for prelims point of view. There is a rattle run of the river Kishtwar district of Jammu and Kashmir. So this is run of the river. That means there is no construction of dam, there is no hydropower projects, but what is happening is just trying to go ahead with usage of the water in regards to the producing electricity by the only run of the river. That is just the flow of the river. Just by the flow of the river. And that is what the difference is now. They wanted to solve the difference that India has gone ahead with the governing the construction. India has gone ahead with the construction of the run of the river. Not hydroelectricity projects, but just on the flow of the river, they are producing the electricity on the Chenab River in the Kishtwar district of Jammu and Kashmir. And India has called for a neutral party. So India is saying we will have a neutral party, but Pakistan is saying we will have the court of arbitration. What do you mean by arbitration? Mediation. So when any two parties X and Y have issues, they have to resolve bilaterally. If the issue is not resolved between both of them, then A will be as a mediator and resolve the issue between X and Y. So Pakistan is saying that we wanted the mediator, that is we will discuss or we will have this in the court of arbitration. So there is a court of arbitration. Who is that court of arbitration which will be actually? That is the World Bank. So they wanted to resolve this hydropower project which is on the Chenab River, India taking up in the, that is through the run of the river. This is very important for prelims and mains point of view, because when there is a question in regards to the Indus Water Treaty between India and Pakistan as part of the international relations in GS paper 2, international relations, Indus Water Treaty will be between India and Pakistan. If the question is asked between India and Pakistan in regards to the Indus Water Treaty, so this is very important. And according to the terms of Indus Water Treaty, India has the right to build ROR projects. Please do understand, India does not have the right on the waters of the western rivers. On the rights on the waters of the western rivers, on the construction of the dams and hydroelectricity projects construction, Pakistan has the rights. But in regards to the, according to the terms of Indus Water Treaty, India has the right to build ROR. So ROR concept is very important. Run of the river projects. That is flow of the river project on the western river, that is Chenab, Jhelum and Indus. So India has what? On the Satluj, Ravi, Bias, SRB. And this treaty has been signed or has come into existence in 1960. But in the year 2016, there has been an attack, that is the Uri attack, that is on our Indian soldiers. So then our Prime Minister Narendra Modi has made it very clear that blood and water could not flow together. This is a very bold statement given by our Prime Minister, said that blood and water cannot flow together. So definitely the water, what is being flown even from the Western River, that is Chenab, Jhelum and Indus, and also from the Satluj, Ravi and Bias. Again, this is again very important from geography point of view, rivers geography point of view. And then India said that it will utilize the hydropower capacity of its share in the Indus system as per the Indus Water Treaty, which has been signed in the year 1960 between India and Pakistan. So the news is just simple, but again we have focused it for mains point of view, international relations between India and Pakistan. So look at it, Indus, Jhelum or Jhelum, however you pronounce, and then Chenab, and then Ravi, Bias or Bias and Satluj. So 6, 3 and 3 divided rivers between India and Pakistan as per the Indus Water Treaty 1960. Why this is in news? And I mean, we should not just focus in regards to this, and we should also focus something else. What is that something else? Is because Pakistan Prime Minister has come up with a new map. Pakistan has come up with or Pakistan new map, wherein it has added JNK, that is almost Gilgit and Baltistan. It has added in its map, and also Junagar, which was part of the princely states. Wherein Junagar was forcefully, when they did not wish to be part of India, the then Home Minister Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, Junagar also was taken into India along with Hyderabad. So the Jammu and Kashmir, Junagar and Sir Creek is been added as part of the new political map of Pakistan. So what is important is link this Indus Water Treaty along with the what Pakistan has come up with the, yeah, Junagar in Gujarat, absolutely Madhu. So Sir Creek, Indus Water Treaty, Jammu and Kashmir, new political map, Jammu and Kashmir, that is Gilgit and Baltistan, Junagar, and then Sir Creek has been added part of the Pakistan new political map. So we have seen recently Nepal has come up with a new political map. Nepal also has come up with a new political map, that is it has added Limpi Yadura and then Kalapani and then Lipu Lake pass as part of Nepal. Fine. And then we also have with China, the issue with India is line of actual control. So India having the issues in regards to the new political map we have seen with because India also has come up with the new political map. India also has come up with a new political map after the abrogation of Article 370 and 35A. India has added Kalapani. India has added Gilgit and Baltistan. India has added Aksai Chin as part of Indian territory. Kalapani of Pitrogarh district of which state? Uttarakhand. Gilgit and Baltistan as part of JNK and Aksai Chin as part of Ladakh. So India has come up with a new political map. Nepal has come up with a new political map, and then Pakistan has also come up with a new political map. So look at the way, and India has come up with the new political map in November 2019, and Nepal almost June-July 2020, and then August 4th Pakistan, August 4th 2020. So almost just exactly 1 year after abrogation of Article 370 in India, Pakistan has come up with the new political map. So these are all very, very important for prelims and also a conceptual understanding for mains point of view. So Azmat Khan has joined. Very good morning to you, Azmat Khan. Welcome to AKS IAS Academy. And the question for the day is for the mains examination: in dealing with the Ladakh confrontation, in dealing with the Ladakh confrontation along the line of actual control with China, India needs US hardware military equipment. Please do understand, this is a question. In dealing with the Ladakh confrontation, that is what I said, LAC, India and China has the face of a skirmish. In dealing with the Ladakh confrontation along the LAC with China, India needs US hardware military equipment, but does not need US troops to fight our battles against China on our border. Comment. This is very superb question. This is very nice question, wherein you can write a very good answer, I think so. But it is a little tricky, because how India will balance between India and US and India and China. So here it is, US and China are at loggerheads, and then India is now in between, and India has very good relation now at this time with US, but here the relations are negative, positive. So how the positive relations between India and US will be encashed to counter China if there is a war-like situation? So, or how will India make sure that it accepts the US troops? When it is accepting US troops, again it is against the sovereignty. So in dealing with the Ladakh confrontation along the line of actual control, India needs hardware military equipment of US, but not US troops. It does not need troops, US troops, to fight our battles against China. Comment. Very good question for you all. And Srikant Balu has joined. Very good morning to you, Balu. Welcome to AKS IAS Academy. And this is the mains question for you. Please do this again in regards to the IR itself. IR, GS paper 2. Or else in regards to how India is actually in a position to use or get that hardware military equipment from US defense, in regards to defense, again national security in regards to defense. So I think this is very good question. You can write it. So I hope this was very, very informative, knowledgeable session for both prelims and mains point of view, because I have emphasized on the keywords and the key phrases across or throughout my session. And this is to recap what we have discussed, recapitulate or recap. So this is again in regards to defense, as I was talking about the Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan scheme, as it is part of the scheme. And this is also a scheme for farmers or agriculture. and this is also for farmers or agriculture scheme. Extremely sorry. And this is again in regards to the developmental initiatives and also from geography map based. And this is again IR point of view. Fine. So I hope this was very knowledgeable and then informative session for you all. So I would say a very big thank you to you all and good luck. Good luck is a result of good planning. So definitely I would say good luck. That means good luck will definitely be part or definitely be a good luck to you only when you have a good planning. Only when you have a good plan. And then please do like the video, share the video and subscribe the video before you sign off. And then do visit AKS IAS Academy Advanced Knowledge System. You can visit through the www.akasis.com website and also you can subscribe the Telegram link t.me/aks.ias. And then see you tomorrow again at 7:30 a.m. Tomorrow 7:30 a.m. And I would say once again, please do maintain or maintain consistency and then stick to your schedule. And then take care of your physical health and mental health. Please do understand what we had it in today's quote of the day. The river will not pass through the rock, not because of its power, but because of its persistence. That is continuous efforts. And this is what is required for a successful students or to reach the goal or to attain the goal or to be a successful is consistency. And thank you and then good luck once again. See you tomorrow. Before I sign off, Bhargav says that thank you so much sir for your DNA class. Thank you very much. And definitely I would assure you that you will be benefited by the daily news analysis of AKS IAS Academy. That I would 100% assure you. And then Satyanara Kota says, nice session sir, we are able to enhance the broader way of information on a particular topic. Yes, thank you very much. So that is what I was saying. I will emphasize on the keywords and the key phrases which will be useful for you both for prelims and mains point of view. That is macro level and micro level explanation would be done from my end, taking into point or covering both mains and prelims point of view. So I would say a very big thank you to you all and then sign off and then take care. Thank you all.